40.
We are in Los 40 Classic with Tears for Fears. Roland, Kurt, thank you very much for being with us.
De nada.
Muchas gracias. And congratulations for your new album, The Tipping Point. First in 17 years. Why did it took so long time?
I mean, there was, you know, there's no specific reason. I think that after Everybody Loves a Happy Ending in 2004, we felt that, you know, it was kind of a nice bookend. We'd gotten back together. It was thoroughly enjoyable to make that record. And then we started touring kind of every year. And the touring side was becoming bigger and bigger. And we were kind of getting more popular touring and getting better at our craft. And eventually, I guess 6 or 7 years ago, we got to the point where we felt the only way to improve the live set would be to record new music. So that was the initial idea, was to really improve the live set. And then management and record company got involved then and suggested we go and kind of write with modern producers, modern hit songwriters. And that didn't go so well. So eventually, all that time had passed, and then at the end of 2019, we sat down, just the two of us, having lost our record company and management, and decided whether we really did want to make an album. If we did, what would it mean? And, you know, how can we do it that had some meaning to us? And once we worked that out, it was actually quite a simple process. So even though the road was long, the actual process of finishing this album was actually very short. It literally took us 3 months.
But some of the new songs were recorded some years ago or just composed?
About half of the album was recorded some years ago, but we had to update that as well once we'd taken over completely. And so we stripped some of it down, stripped some of it back, re-recorded vocals, changed lyrics. I would say the heart and soul of the album, the healing part of the album, the part of the album that sounds a bit more relaxed, serene and calm, comes from 2020.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like the calm and peaceful songs like Rivers of Mercy and that kind of songs. Yes. Are you living both in America now, or where are you now?
I'm in England.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. Roland has many homes.
That's cool.
I am in Los Angeles.
Silver tongue will soon be gone when the sunlight hits the room. Lay down with them if you want. Watch their breath and feel the cold.
And the Tipping Point, it's like Tears for Fears' amazing comeback song, and also the name of the album, but also sounds like a goodbye song for the people you loved and their struggles between life and death, isn't it?
Yes, it's a very, Tipping Point is a very sad song, personally. It's a love song for the dying. It was inspired by the period in which my late wife was becoming more and more ill. With mental illness, alcoholism, it was a pretty rough time for everyone involved. And the tipping point in that sense is the tipping point between life and death. It's when the narrator is in a hospital ward looking at someone who is about to pass, but he's unsure when that transition occurs, whether they're still alive in memory, whether they've soul has moved on, whether they're now an empty shell, what has exactly gone on here? But the name of the Tipping Point as the name of the album is a bit more, less personal and more sort of social. Kurt can explain this very well, but it's really about the state of the world at the moment and the state of the world that it has been for quite a few years now. The various tipping points. It's a word, it's a phrase that you'll see cropping up a lot.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a lot more global than the personal meaning of the song, The Tipping Point. You know, if you look at what's gone on worldwide, be that politically the rise of the right wing or the Black Lives Matter movement or the Me Too movement, or even the pandemic, climate crisis, need I go on? But we definitely find ourselves at a tipping point. And, especially in news and in the way information is shared. Because I think, as I said in the previous interview, that there's this sort of, for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. So there's this point where everything has gone here. So everything became, certainly in America, very right-wing biased, especially with Donald Trump in power, and then suddenly everything has to go the other way. So you have this reaction against it, which is extreme left-wing. And your desire is not to have either. Your desire is to have balance. So I think that the tipping point to me is talking about that desire for balance in everything.